No, Farmville, no. Stop harassing me using social media. Hello to you and thank you very much for joining. Today I'm introducing a new show called What Annoys Me. And if you didn't know this already about me, I'm the type of person that gets annoyed by everything. These lights. Every video I say about the lights, I only can bother to put one up and it's right in front of me, and you shouldn't really do that, and it's blinding me. I find everything annoying. Don't look at me like that, because at the end of this video you'll be relating so hard. Basically, I have the ability to find annoying things in everything, and I'm going to share those with you today and in future episodes. This is the worst ITV show in the world. Each episode will take a topic or thing, whatever, and I'll basically tell you what I find annoying about them and hope that you can relate. Now, the first topic, I have just realised something about it. It's Facebook, and probably isn't the best idea given what's in the news about Facebook this week. I'm just going to tell you what I find annoying about Facebook. This is the most original series on YouTube ever. No one has ever done anything like this before, I can guarantee it. Well, now don't get me wrong, I love Facebook. I use it every day and it's one of my favourite platforms. But that don't mean it don't have its flaws. I don't know how to speak. I literally just have one word to say and you'll be on board with this idea. Poking. What is the deal with poking? So-and-so has just poked you, like... I think, to me, it invokes one of three reactions, none of which are positive. Number one is, someone just poked you. How the F dare you? You go and poke yourself. Honestly. Number two is, someone just poked you. Okay, great. Really don't give a crap right now, so why don't you bugger off? Number three is, someone just poked you. Why? Why did you do that? Was there any need? No, it's hurtful, that's what it is. Hold on to your hats, I'm about to say something controversial. Poking is the equivalent of pineapple on pizza. It's not necessary. I've just made a few people turn off. As if that many people were watching in the first place. Oh, I'm so hard on myself. Have you ever been scrolling down your Facebook newsfeed and you just had a really great time looking at all these posts? And all of a sudden a notification pops up, a little red one on the world sign, and you're like, oh my god, I have a friend, someone wants to talk to me, this is the best thing that's ever happened to me in my life. Judy wants to ask for some lives on Candy Crush. Are you being serious, Judy? Really? Effing Farmville requests. I cannot deal with Farmville anymore. I haven't downloaded it. I'm not going to download it because I don't want it to ruin my life. Side note. Right. Facebook ads. Ads in general on apps need to get up with the times, modern times, and show a bit of variety, because the only ad on the App Store apps and stuff that I see is for homescapes or gardenscapes. Let me tell you something, I'm having nightmares of that bald dude who constantly is renovating his garden and house. What is your problem? Anyone know his name? Leave it in the comments so I can go and write an angry letter to homescapes and gardenscapes. People who made that, and tell them that they're producing nightmares for me. Why? Haven't you renovated your house by now? I'm going to be picking the same... Stupid dude! But please do sponsor me. I need them. This is a message to all the parents. Maybe not the parents, maybe just weird ass people. I love the fact that you've got Facebook. Not like. I love the fact that you've got Facebook. But now that you know how to tag people in things, can you stop tagging me in literally everything you see? Because it's really annoying. Oh, I've got 15 notifications. They're all from your mother. That doesn't look sad, does it? I mean, I've got no social life anyway, so it doesn't matter. Especially... Mom! when those posts involve parts that rhyme with angina or Venus, I do not want to see a post about a Japanese festival full of Venuses. I'm gonna go. Two words, duck face. That was my script falling. Duck off, just go away with your duck face. Go and swim in some ponds and eat bread. I could literally go on for days about talking about the kinds of posts that you see on Facebook. You know, the annoying ones, all of them. And I'm not gonna say all of them because, oh, the most annoying I'm hearing someone saying, great. That would be the posts that ask people whether they're about. Like, I'm bored, who wants to go out with me? Like, go away. One, I only became friends with you on Facebook, so I can say I've had more friends. And two, there are so many other things you can be doing when you're bored. Go on the internet and find a list. Read a book. I don't read, so that's a bit far-fetched to me. Do some, cook, okay? Watch the television. There's so many nice films out there nowadays. Flipping, go for a run. I can't even get through that word. Running. I'm unfit. I am not saying that you shouldn't go out and drink, because people like to drink, okay? I'm not saying that alcohol is bad for you. Well, it is bad for you. But you know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that people who go out and drink all night are horrible people, because they're not. But life is too short to go out every single night and get absolutely, I can't even say that word, absolutely twatted with your best mates. Honestly, go and freaking have a burger. I'm bored, want to go out? But no, even if you were my friends who were saying that, which, well, they wouldn't, because they know what I'm like, and I would instantly say, go away right now. Even if you're my friends and you posted that, I would tell you to go away. Come out with me. Who's about? Who wants to go to this? No, leave me the F alone. I would much rather eat a whole pizza to myself and binge watch Stranger Things. Thank you very much. Again, I'm so unfit. I've never actually ever done that, eating a whole pizza, because I do it almost every week. No? Just me? Okay. It's embarrassing. I could make this point in relation to the other point about posts, because it is a post, but it's so ridiculous and big, I'm going to make it my own point in this show. And that is chain posts. You know the ones that say, a little girl's going to stand by your bed tonight and murder you in your sleep? That is if you don't share this post with 10 other people. You think I'd be on Facebook if I had 10 friends? I don't have 10 friends. I have 2. At most, not including my family. Oh, that's 10, isn't it? I've got 10 friends. That's sad. Fine, you've posted that. First of all, I don't believe you, because once upon a time, a long time ago, I once purposely didn't share this post because it said, share this post or this person that you know will be run over by a car. Now, I'm not condoning me wanting to kill this person, because I don't want to kill this person, possibly just give them a fright and knock them over with a car, because I really didn't like them, okay? I didn't like them. Did they get run over by a car? No, they didn't. I purposely prayed that night, please, I've not shared this Facebook post on purpose, because I want bleeped person's name to be run over by a car. I don't want to kill them, don't kill them, because I'm not that type of person. Just, you know, knock them out. Did anything happen? No, nothing happened. So I don't believe them anymore. I'm just kidding! I'm going to jail. If I did believe any of this BS, then I would have been run over by a car, my mum would have been killed by an escaped convict in her sleep, and my entire family would have been crushed to death in an earthquake. So, you know, pros and cons. Stop your BS! Stop sending these! this. No, nothing's going to happen. Why don't you write something? Like, you're very creative, but write something a little bit more creative and original than this little ghost girl is going to come in your sleep and slit your throat. Like, write a book, okay? Because you should. And flipping go and do something constructive. Have a McDonald's. That's the best thing in the world. I could do with a McDonald's now, actually. Do you want to know something funny? My first ever friend request on Facebook, which happened, can I add, 2 seconds after I logged into my very first time on Facebook, was from somebody from Scarborough. Boy, say anything, no, it's not the Canadian Scarborough. This is the one in the UK. I don't even know where that is. Well, they just thought, oh, a new person's logged in. Friend, are you very sad? I'm pretty sure I'm probably still friends with them, to be honest. Actually, why wasn't it any of my friends that knew I was getting Facebook and already had Facebook? Yes, I could quite easily go to your profile and send you a friend request. Why didn't no one do that for me? I'm so sad. I do applaud Facebook for knowing my interests. If you don't know me, I love quizzes. I love trivia, I love online quizzes, anything like that. Find out which friend's character of you. Oh my God. You name it. That fact is actually on my CV. That doesn't scream gigantic nerd, does it? Facebook knows this fact. I don't know how, actually, that's quite creepy. But so every other one of my sponsored posts, in fact, most of my posts that are not people who I'm friends with posting, are about like online quizzes and BuzzFeed quizzes and magic quiz and stuff like that. And every so often there's this one that you look at and you go, oh my God, I really want to take that quiz. For example, just this morning I did a which everyone is two kinds of Disney characters combined, which was one by BuzzFeed, I remember that. And I got, what was it? Disgust from Inside Out. And Mike Wazowski, I'm not that round, how rude. All green. And I thought, oh, I really want to do that quiz. Right. That's an example of a quiz I really want to do. Sometimes you get those, and this never happened with BuzzFeed, but sometimes you get those quizzes. Which it's for a website that you maybe never heard of, or not like big as BuzzFeed. And you think, oh, I really want to do that quiz. And then you get to it, and all of a sudden this pops up. It's make an account to do this quiz. I'm sorry, I didn't realise I had to challenge my computer skills, which you should know I have none of by now. I wanted to challenge my knowledge and brain power. Not gonna... So, okay, breakdown. I really wanted this quiz. Let's make an account. You have to pay for a subscription to this website to do this quiz. Like, hell to the no. Okay, I'm never saying that again. I'm never saying that again either. That's another one to add to the list. Okay, I'm going to stop it there. I'm going to stop talking about Facebook now because I'm going to lose the chance one day to ever sponsor them. So, as if that's a bit faster. So, thank you very much for listening. I could go on, but my mouth's dry and I want some something to drink. So, thank you very much for watching this video. Comment, like, and subscribe. I'm just going to say that. I don't really want to say it because I don't want to have to force you into doing things you don't want to do, but do it, please. So, I'm going to go now because I'm quite frankly bored of being up here. Okay, bye-bye. Ooh, 360 video.